I studied architecture in Belgium, where I was born and I grew up. As a teenager, I was very interested in art, in drawing and painting, and also in designing. The modernist architecture has always inspired me, and also the work of Tadao Ando in Japan. I practiced architecture in Belgium for about 4 years before immigrating to Sydney about 20 years ago. Compared to Europe, I thought the architecture was quite traditional here. Since then, a lot has changed, and I think it's become more modern now. I wanted to build a house where it was nice to live in. It had a nice, comfortable feel to it. Comfortable in the way that energy efficiency, the flow of the house, the indoor areas flowing towards the outdoor areas. I chose this site because I really like the outlook, and this site has views over the valley. It is a sloping site though, which meant that we had to come up with a split level home design to fit the site. There were certain challenges. We had to design the home over different levels. We also had to put in a number of retaining walls outside to make the outdoors more accessible. And the retaining walls were built with the permanent formwork. We pretty much used concrete all the way through. So we used concrete for the internal walls, external walls for the slabs, even for the water tank. By using concrete for the water tank, I could locate the tank underneath the garage, and the tank is part of the building, it's not added on. One of the benefits of a house built in concrete is that it's more resistant to bushfires. I used an ICF wall construction for the external walls. ICF stands for Insulating Concrete Forms. It's a styrofoam block system, which is then filled with reinforcement steel and poured with concrete, and it's got a very high insulation value. I certainly think there's a lot of advantages. I think the first advantage is that the building is tied together really well because it's all one material. The other benefit would be that once the blocks are up, if there are still changes you would like to make, you can still make them before actually finalizing it by pouring the concrete. There's no delay when the weather gets bad. Only the pour would be affected by the rain. The advantages of using concrete for the upper floors is the sound reduction, so you don't get the noise going through the slab as you do in traditional builds. The external walls have been finished off with an acrylic render, which has a color in it, so there's no need for repainting. With an addition of a powder-coated aluminium window and color-bond steel roof, the building is pretty much maintenance-free. I think there's been a big change because people are realizing that it's important to have an energy-efficient house. Very often, the construction method contributes to the way the internal of a house performs, and therefore, people are looking at different ways of constructing a home.